Hey, this is Jonathan Lewis with Superior Welding and Fabrication. Wanted to give you a little story on where we started with the journey of our online sales. So about 7-8 years ago, we started selling welding coupons for the request of our customers. And in selling those coupons, it led into some of the things we're gonna talk about today, the aerospace weld test fixtures that you can use for your aerospace welding, your schools, certifications, practice, and so on and so forth. So about 7 or 8 years ago, I had a desire to actually make one of these. So I had a friend that had a manual machine shop who actually made me a weld test fixture for my own personal use. I still have block today, and we still do use that in our training sessions. So when we made that block, I decided, hey, why not take a picture of it, post it online, and see if we can sell it. Many years later, we've sold hundreds of these things. It's had several different changes, and that is where it started, which is the desire to create something for myself, and then a product that I could sell to a customer and be used for you and your testing and your certifications. All right, so if you go back to our original variant, the very first block that we made was made out of an aluminum base and actually copper hold downs. And so it was done that way for the very specific reason of that's what I had. I had an aluminum block that was left over from scrap, and I had some copper that we ended up using for hold downs that were left over from our project. So when I approached a friend, I said, hey, can you make me one of these test fixtures out of aluminum and copper? Well, obviously copper is very expensive. And so it led into what we have here today, the aluminum base stay. We have an aluminum hold down with a steel hold down option as well. And it kind of looks good, you know, kind of stuck with that because it looks shiny and pretty, and that's what we want. One of the properties that aluminum has for like aerospace weld testing is the aluminum does pull the heat out of your material, the material that you're using for a weld test. And so we'll show pictures of this here, but like for example, titanium. By putting this in there, it helps draw the heat out and it makes it look the way that it should when taking a test. It allows you to pass so far as your coloring and everything, and it just pulls the heat out very, very well, very effective in pulling the heat out. You can see here's a stainless version of that, and it pulls the heat out very well. Back in the day, they actually used a lot of steel, and that works pretty good too, but this pulls it out a little bit faster than your steel versions. So another characteristic of making it out of aluminum is obviously it's lighter. You know, it is arguably stronger in some ways, but it is lighter for you to handle and for you to use. The other thing that works really good is if you do accidentally put a weld on the aluminum, it shouldn't stick, at least unless you're welding aluminum. So over the years, we've been asked, why aluminum specifically? You know, why can't we just use it the way that we used to do back in the day? Steel or whatever we had laying around. And so arguably, aluminum will put less impurities or zero impurities into your metals like titanium, Inconels, and stainless as well. You won't have that rust to deal with where you can leave your fixture laying around and it'll accumulate rust. That does create a problem when you're welding something that's going to be x-rayed and you don't want that rust and impurities in there. And so arguably aluminum will be able to last for a very long time, if not forever, and won't contaminate what you're going to be welding. So why do you need a weld test fixture from SuperiorWeldAndFab.com? Well, there's a lot of things. One is if you are an aerospace shop, let's say for example, and you needed to take a weld test to that code, D17.1, and you wanted to create the best quality you can in taking your weld test fixtures, the repeatability that's offered by using these fixtures are for you. You can set your guys up to be able to take the same test back to back. You can allow these to cool back out to ambient temperature or whatever temperature you decided, so the tests are absolutely repeatable. It allows you to suck the heat out of that as well. It also works out for your other certifications, D1.6, your stainless steel, or some of your sheet metal certifications. So it's not limited to D17.1 or your aerospace, but it also will work out for your sheet metal certifications as well. One example of that would be D1.6. If we wanted to do a structural certification in TIG, let's say, and this is 060, you could use this fixture to take your D1.6 weld test on there and submit that for bend tests or whatever the customer wants, or D17.1. You know, you got your titanium. You got your titanium that you would use a lot commonly in aerospace there. This fixture or the bit large fixture will allow you to take that test and allow that repeatability that you would want between each employee that you have taking the test. Another option for you would be as an individual. If you wanted to purchase this for you and your shop, let's say me and my shop, I wanted to get my shop certified D17.1 for doing some aerospace repairs or flight service parts there. This fixture will work out perfect for you as well. You're not spending the time taking off your shop to make one yourself. You simply click a button and this shows up a couple days later, and there you go. You're ready to go to take your aerospace test for you and for your shop and get you in compliance with what your customer wants. So what comes in the package when you're buying a weld test fixture from SuperiorWeldandFab.com? Well, obviously you get your block, you get your hole down. Standard right now, it comes with the aluminum hole down. Steel hole downs are an option as well. You will get all the hardware that you would need to put this together and to use right out of the box. So you're gonna have your argon port, and you can pick either side that you want to use that on, a plug to plug the other side so you don't lose that argon, because obviously you want the argon to flow through the middle, right? And then you've got your bolts that will hold this down. The weld test fixture is primarily designed for a material up to 125 or 0.125 thousandths thick. It will do pretty much unlimited thickness, but you will have to get longer bolts to go up to your bigger stuff. Commonly we see customers that purchase these go up to like 3/8 thick. But again, these bolts don't support that. All right, so let's go over some of the common setup features with setting up different types of material. So it depends on the thickness in which you're testing and the size in which you're testing. These are pretty universal. We've made them to fit most everybody's needs and the different thickness range that you are going to be welding, all the way from like 10 or 20 thousandths, like I said, all the way up to 3/8. But the common use is 63,000, 60 or 30 thousandths up to 125. So here we've got some 60,000 stainless, just as an example to use. These are 2-inch by 5-inch, work great for your welder qualifications, some of your testing that you would do with that as well. And so when you're putting these in, I've already got one piece sitting in here, ready to go. We're gonna put the second piece on there. Obviously these will be prepped according to how you want them to be done. Set them in the fixture here, bolt it back down, and you're off to the races. You're ready to weld. So one of the unique features of our weld test fixture is over the years we developed pockets in here that allow you to do different widths on here to allow you to suck heat out if you want heat sucked out, or allow you to pull the hole downs away if you want to take out less heat. For example, stainless steel coupons we have here, I can push my hole downs all the way up to my weld if I so desired. Now you can do that to suck the heat out really quickly, depending on what you exactly want to do. Or if I'm doing something maybe like aluminum, you want to put the blocks farther away so you don't want to suck the heat out, you can do that as well. It really just depends on what you or your customer requires. And so the hole downs are not locked into one spot. You've got three holes to allow you to adjust these all the way to the end or as close as you want. And it just makes it really unique and universal for your different types of materials and thicknesses. Okay, so another benefit of the weld test fixture is the ability to slide your hand along the hole down while you're welding. Now that's an advantage because our very first one, we stuck our bolts up above and allowed you to catch your hand. I've got a torch that has nothing on it, just for an example piece right now. You can see here that I'm able to just rest my hand, my gloved hand, when you're welding, right? And I'm able to rest my hand on here and slide it right along where I'm gonna weld, creating a nice, even, and consistent weld for your testing. So what about your weld positions? So one of the common questions that we get is, Jonathan, how do these work for your 1G, 2G, 3G, and 4G positions? Well, obviously you can just stand them up for like your 3G, you can lay it horizontally for your 2G, clamp it to something for your above 4Gs. And so that's one thing that you're gonna have to get creative with. We looked at doing other options with holes in the back, but at the end of the day, you're gonna have to get creative. What I do with it is I'll stand it up like for a 3G and clamp it to an angle iron, a fixture piece on your fixture table, whatever the case is. Simple and easy, allowing you to get to the position that you need to weld in. With your different positions you have there, one of the recommendations that I would throw out there is if you're gonna do a 3G, argon is heavier than air. So put your argon port on the top and allow your argon to flow down through the purge side. All right, what about your guys that are doing your welding procedures? Well, we have our 14-inch hole down that allows you to do 12-inch long coupons. These are for your shops that are starting fresh, that are starting with D17-1, need to do your welding procedures, and allows you to do the larger plates. About 4 or 5 years ago, we found the need to offer a second fixture, and that's where this one came from, actually. So this allows you to do the bigger coupons. One thing I will throw out there is if you're going to be doing both your procedures and your welder qualifications, this one fixture will do the job for you. For example, so I have a 2-inch by 5-inch stainless steel coupon here. So you can simply set this in here, obviously hold it down, block off this other side with some high temperature tape or aluminum foil of some sort, and it allows you to do your welder qualifications. And you can do your welding procedures by simply just setting the big piece in there, and you're good to go. The pocket that we have machined in these blocks is 12.5 inches long. So it allows you to do your full 12-inch welder qualifications with no problems whatsoever. All right, what about warpage? So another common question that I see a lot is, what about my plates when they warp? Well, there's a lot of concerns when it comes to warpage here. You can see in our big blocks, we've got actually six holes or six hold downs. The middle hold downs will not work with your standard 4x12 coupons that you're gonna be welding. And so you're gonna have to omit those for your larger pieces. The alternative to that is to use your outside four and then just simply clamp the center down. We've looked at all kinds of different options, but without getting too fancy, that's honestly the easiest way to go. All right, so I've went ahead and thrown this aluminum welding procedure plate back inside of here just to show you what it looks like. As you can see here, it fits in there very well. It allows you also to do a coupon that is wider. Commonly also, we get people that will do like a 6-inch individual pieces, so 6-inch by 12-inch. So when they're done welding, it's 12-inch by 12-inch. Everybody does it a little bit different, but this is 4-inch by 12-inch, which gives you 8x12 when you're done. And as you can see, it fits in here very, very well. So another thing that is commonly asked is, what about warpage? And every plate that you're gonna weld is going to warp. That's just the way that it works. But you can see here with our 125 aluminum, simply we just undo it and it comes right out. We also have the optional steel hold downs if that's a concern for you to bend these. And so far, the many years that I've been actually doing these, we have yet to break a single one. All right, results speak for themselves. And so you might say, what can we expect when we're taking a weld test this way? Well, here's a titanium example that obviously was welded ahead of time. On the top side, you can see there was very good shielding on there. The hold downs were held very close to keep the cooling down. But the proof is in the footage on the backside. Now, I'm not too thrilled with this line right here, but perfectly acceptable in what we're testing here. You can see it's nice and shiny, nice and clean. No discoloration that would allow you to fail on a D17.1 welding inspection on there. We also have a stainless example that we have here. As you can see on the backside, perfectly good. You have your straw color that you want to use or better on the backside, as well as decent coloring on the front side. Now the front side can be better with the use of a trailing shield or better shielding gas on the torch that you have there. But on the backside, the results that we're looking for our weld test fixtures, perfectly acceptable with that. Another thing I want to talk about is the recommended gas flows that you would use in your weld test fixtures. I've had customers give me feedbacks in different ranges, but for the most part, 10 CFH works pretty good on the small one, and 10 to 20 CFH in that range will work on the big ones. That's gonna be very dependent on the size of the coupon they're gonna be welding. You know, a 5-inch coupon or a 6-inch coupon or a 10-inch coupon, etc. How much you have open on your screens on the bottom side there, you're gonna have to play with that on your side. But those will give you a general guidelines. For the most part, it seems to be from 10 to 20 CFH works really good for your argon purge. So who owns these? That's a common question too. Who in the world has these in their shop? Well, I can confidently tell you that we have these in shops ranging from the guy in their garage, which is where I started out, all the way to your big name rocket companies that are sending things up into space and satellites that are common today, as well as those that are trying to get there as well. Just about every branch of the government owns these and uses them for their aerospace and their testing programs. And the majority of the private companies that are doing aerospace as well. I can also share you that most of the airline companies that are out there have these and use them as well. Now, why do I say that? I'm not saying that necessarily to brag, but I am saying that as a great accomplishment. Starting in our garage many years ago and selling these and testing these over the years, that's a great point of pride for me and my brother-in-law, who actually does all the machining on these. And so that's great when you can think about the testing that these are being used for the end customer's needs. Where do I see the weld test fixtures in the future? Well, obviously I'd like to see these in every shop. Not every shop out there realistically is gonna use a weld test fixture, nor do you need a weld test fixture for everything that you're doing. But I would like to see these in more schools. Schools have really been picking up on their aerospace testing as well as the sheet metal certifications that can go along with these test fixtures. And so our big push today is actually pushing these for the schools, the technical schools, the career centers that are purchasing these, thankfully in quantities, allowing their students to get a taste of aerospace. One of the common things we get asked about these through schools is they relay to us that they want their students to get a feel for aerospace. Maybe they've got aerospace in their areas, you know, your SpaceX's, your Blue Origins, or your military divisions that are out there. And so they want to give their kids a taste of testing to that or welding to those aerospace specifications. Another area we want to see with these is improvements. We got the steel hold downs that allow you to put more force in theory on these blocks for the thicker materials that you'll be welding, and then just making general improvements. There's always improvements that we can make on these. When I first started doing these to where they are today is leaps and bounds. You know, they weren't fully machined. These are 100% made in the USA, machined from start to finish out of US material. And so that's a great source of pride for us. And even our screens, even the way that we diffuse the argon on the backside has really changed and is proprietary to us. So if you're making a decision to purchase a weld test fixture for your specific needs, again, whether it be aerospace, sheet metal, or just practicing in your shop, first thing, give us a call. I'd be more than happy to answer any questions that you have with this, meaning that I have the experience with making these as well as weld testing two different codes. I'm more than happy to answer the questions you would have and how these would best suit you for your needs. So far as customer support, we're here for you for the long haul. So one of the things that I do is I will get on the phone with you and I will help you the best I can answering any questions you would have with the initial purchase. You can also get with us on consulting. We do consulting and training, obviously for a fee, and we can come in there or you can come to us and we can help you with your procedures or your weld testing for your guys and girls, and we'll help you with that as well. Customer support for the long term, obviously with these, if there's anything that goes wrong, we're always going to take care of you. So far we've had no one totally destroy one yet, but I guess there's always a first time. We also offer the weld coupons that will go with these. You can purchase your titaniums, your Inconels, your stainless, your aluminum, your welding procedure plates, even into your structural steel. That's how we can support you with these weld test fixtures. We can provide for you the coupons that you even need, making it very turnkey. Oftentimes we have customers that purchase these and purchase their welding coupons, and so you get everything in one shot and you're good to go. So how do you purchase one? That's the big question, right? Head over to superiorweldandfab.com where we have everything that we currently offer there in stock, ready to ship. Usually we ship the next day after your purchase. Now, if you need them next day air, we can take care of that too. Currently right now, we ship the standard USPS because it makes it very affordable and we have very good luck with them here of late. But if you need these expedited or you have another need, we can use any of the other shipping carriers and send them to you that way as well. If you have a need outside of the U.S., shoot us an email at superiorweldandfab@gmail.com and we'll take care of you as well. We actually have shipped these all over the world, which is another source of pride for us as well. So why should you purchase one of ours versus one of the competitors? Now, I'm never one to make fun of a competitor, nor do I want to be that kind of a person, but there are some advantages of what we sell versus some of the things that are out there today. One of the things we have noticed with some of the ones that are out there on the market today is they warp. Feedback we've got from our customers that have some of the other ones that are out there have told us that they warp and generally don't do as good a job of purging. Now, I'm not saying that at all, making fun of them whatsoever, but ours are 2 inches thick so far as our bottom blocks. These are 3/4 inch thick. And again, we're using your steel variants of that as well. It makes it really hard to warp, and that can be important depending on what you're going to be welding out there today. Next thing for us is the proprietary way that we diffuse the argon or the shielding gas that you're going to use on the backside of your choice. Ours is very unique in the way that we're doing it, and we've had very good success over the years. It works really, really well as is.